Elizabeth, thanks. In less than an hour, the ETSU Bucks football team will hold its first scrimmage since head football coach Randy Sanders was on paid administrative leave.
In 4 days since the university announced the investigation surrounding a potential violation of university policy, ETSU really has yet to specify exactly what incident prompted the investigation. Carissa Winstead joins us live from the William B. Green Jr. Stadium, where many questions surrounding the investigation remain unanswered.
Yeah, Josh and Sarah, one of those questions is, what is the timeline for this investigation? And according to ETSU, there isn't one. I'm going to step out of the way so you can see the football team is already coming on the field to warm up without coach Randy Sanders. Now, ETSU placed him on paid administrative leave as it investigates a potential violation of a university policy, not an NCAA policy. But it's still unclear what that policy is or what happened.
On Tuesday, just one day after East Tennessee State University placed head football coach Randy Sanders on paid administrative leave, the team held practice without him.
I had a lot of energy. Everybody come out ready to work.
Coaches acting if Sanders were there and said the team had a positive attitude on the field. Sanders wasn't in attendance, but ETSU President Dr. Brian Nolan was. I saw him walking off the field with Athletic Director Scott Carter. Tonight, the football team will hit the field for its first scrimmage since Sanders was placed on leave.
I think Coach Sanders has done a good job of coming in, and, you know, obviously he wanted to install the base of his offense, and at the same time, we're always talking about, okay, who are the playmakers? Who do we need to get the ball to?
With just over 3 months of head coaching experience under his belt, Sanders is making national headlines. ESPN, CBS Sports, USA Today, and other outlets all reporting his leave and questioning what happened. Joe Hodges, a graduate and supporter of ETSU football, says despite the national attention, Sanders has support.
It may have made national news, but there's been a lot of people calling in on social media and everything and fully in support of Coach Sanders, and we support Coach Sanders, and I think he's doing a fine job with the university.
Sanders is not allowed on campus as the investigation continues, and according to ETSU, there is no timeline for the investigation. But coaches at ETSU tell me they don't think he will be gone long.
We're keeping everything as normal as it can be, and we know that Coach Sanders will be back with us.
And I did reach out to Texas A&M, which is where several of Sanders' former co-workers are coaching at the moment. I was hoping to hear from them about working with Sanders, but I've yet to hear back. And I also reached out to ETSU booster Jerry Robertson for his thoughts on the investigation. He did not want to comment. Sarah?